I think there are quite a few people in our audience standing at the back door of their church saying, just give me one good reason not to walk out.
I was really dark about the future of the church.
I just kept running up against Christians who were awful.
People were just up in arms, you know, how dare you? And I was like, what is happening right now?
Donald Trump tweeted about your very dark heart.
Yes. Nasty, nasty man with no heart.
I assume you didn't think at the time that criticizing Trump would turn out to be as big a deal as it turned out to be.
Oh, no, I knew exactly how big a deal it was. Yeah, yeah.
I didn't set out to write a book about the dark side of American evangelicalism.
I would say things like, we got to take care of the poor. Amen, brother. We got to take care of the disenfranchised. Amen, brother. And we should speak up about these unarmed black people getting killed in the streets. Hold on, brother.
Oh, in the silence of despairing, in the waking, in the night.
Of course, I'm like, I'm done with this whole thing. I'm out of here.
You can say what you want about me or make the claims and call me a wolf or a heretic or a false teacher, you know. Honestly, sometimes it's exhausting to have to prove myself to other Christians that I'm a Christian.
That sense of exile, it was very hard for that part of me not to hear, depart from me, you worker of iniquity, I never knew you.
Come to me.
Lecrae.
Kristin Du Mez.
Jemar Tisby. Russell Moore. Why are you still a Christian?
Why I'm Still a Christian, a Holy Post sub-series premiering September 18th.